Jesus, we're thankful for your presence. We're thankful that we can just come before your throne in adoration and thanksgiving. And thank you for freedom and liberty to worship and to be just completely abandoned in what we do in order to lift up your name. So all over this place, could we just give an uproarious applause to the Lord God Almighty and shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah. Here we go. Clap your hands, all you people. Hey, hey. Make a joyful noise. Step out of shadows. Step out of light. Hey. Break into the wild. And don't be afraid. Here we go. Run into wide open spaces, His grace is waiting for you. Dance like the weight has been lifted, His grace is waiting. 'Cause where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom, there is freedom. Yes! Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom, there is freedom. Come out of the dark, just as you are, into the fullness of His love. For the Spirit is here, let there be freedom. Have you been set free in this place today? Dance like the weight has been lifted. Grace is waiting. Dance like the weight has been lifted. Grace is shout like the weight has. Shout like the weight has been lifted.
Fly, fly. But I know that they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name. We've heard that there is no way through. We've heard the tide will never change. They haven't seen what you can.
Power. love that scripture in the Bible that says that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And I could point out so many different parts and seasons in my life where I know God worked a miracle. My mom is alive today because God is able. My friend Crystal is alive today because God is able. But I think it's important, and the Bible even says, to tell of these things that God has done. Why? Because it is His will be done. And if we are the light of the world, we share that light, and we talk about what God has done, and we say, friends, family, guess what God did for me today? Guess how the Lord moved in my life today? That is the word of our testimony. And ultimately, if we can say that God has saved our lives, saved our souls, that is the reason that we believe for it. And He shows us these things so that we can have faith for the things that He is going to continue to do. Because He's not done. He's not done. And so if you have a need in this room today, know that He is able. And He is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think. But He still wants to be asked. Knock on the door and it shall be open unto you. So we're going to proclaim faith in this room right now. And we're going to believe for the miracle, not even just for ourselves, but for our family and our neighbors and our city and our country. We've got to let the light in, guys. We've got to open up the window and let the light in. So God, we pray in the name of Jesus, Your will be done and Your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. And Lord, for every need, spoken and unspoken today, God, we know that You are able and You hold it all in the palm of Your hand. So we sing, we say, and we believe in Your word. If You said, then I believe. You said, it is done. You said, so I believe. You said, it is done. Sing it out. Say, You said, so I believe. You said, it is done. You said, so I'm gonna believe. You said, it is done. I have faith for You said, I'm gonna believe. You said, God, You said, proclaim with your hand clap right now. Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe. God, we believe. God, we believe forever.
God, you have the final say. You have the name above all names. At your name, darkness bows. At your name, darkness flees. We lift up your name today, God. Come on, you give life. You give life. You are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope and you restore every heart that is broken. Go ahead and tell them, great are you, Lord. That's right, that's right. Oh, come on, it's your breath. It's your sing. Great are you, Lord. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore, God.
Yeah.
the scripture says that the Lord has exalted Jesus high and given him a name that is above every other name. And given him a name that is above every single thing. That means that the name of Jesus reigns above darkness. That means that the name of Jesus reigns above depression. That means that the name of Jesus reigns above anxiety and reigns above addiction. And so when we lift up the name of Jesus, darkness flees, chains break, sickness bows, depression ceases. All the earth will shout the praises of our Most High King Jesus. Oh Lord, let's lift high his name. Come on, just begin to sing the name of Jesus right now over whatever situation you're going through, whatever anxiety or problem that you're facing. He is mighty. He is worthy of all praise and all adoration. Jesus, be enthroned on the praises of the people right now. Come on, let it rise. Your breath.
It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise.
That's right.
Pour out our praise.
It's your breath, it's your breath, it's your breath.
Says that the Lord inhabits the praises of his people, so we can know that he's here with us right now. He's among us. He's working. He's moving in this place. The scripture also says that the Lord is enthroned upon the praises of his people. And just like Caden was saying, you know, the battle's already won. He's already there. It's almost like a reminder to the enemy, like, hey, just remember you lost. What I think is so great, even further still, is that the praise of God's people confounds the enemy. Do you get that? In the midst of all that could be coming against you, the people of God have a chance to just totally confuse every motive and trick of the enemy, because we know our God is great and greatly to be praised. And in the midst of whatever it is that we walk through, we praise him. We praise him, and I love it. I love it. He's got tactics and plans, and if the people of God actually did what the scripture tells us to, and we praised in the midst of it, if we look at the news and we start feeling the spirit of fear come upon us, and instead of falling into that lie of the enemy, instead we praised and we reminded the enemy that our God is not the author of confusion. He's not the author of fear. And we know how the story ends. So no matter what people try to tell you these days, the church will remain alive. The church is strong. We know how the story ends. So we can praise. We can sing. It's his breath. He's given us breath in our lungs so that we may return the praise back to him. And this morning, I just felt led to say that because I don't know what you walked in here with, but I know that we all walk in here with something. I walked in here tired as could possibly be. We've been going for, I've been up for 48 hours. I know that's in your body. Some of you walked in here with a spirit of doubt, a spirit of confusion, a spirit of depression, anxiety. I don't know what it is, but I know that the enemy is trying to come against the body of Christ right now, because the body of Christ is rising up. But I just wonder what would happen in this place if every person in this room confounded the enemy with our praise. And in the midst of all that he's trying to do, and we know no weapon formed against us will prosper, so we don't have to even worry about it. Instead, we fix our eyes on Jesus, and we praise the name that is above every other name. We praise the name that breaks all the strongholds of the spirits of the enemy. We praise the name that in the name is the fullness of all that he is. And he is healer, he is redeemer, he is provider. Jesus. Let's sing that chorus one more time. We're not going to build, we're not going to try to hype this. We're just going to look the enemy straight in the face and be like, get confused, devil. Get confused. Because no matter what, I have faith in a God that's bigger, that's higher, that's greater. And it's his breath in my lungs. And he's worthy of it. He deserves it. But more than that, I want to give it to him this morning. Because I just know he's that good. It's your breath. Come on. In our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath. Come on. In our lungs. And so we pour out your praise. And it's your breath in all of us. And so we pour, I fix my eyes on you, Jesus. And it's your breath in all of us. And so we pour out our praise to you. And we know that all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. Dead bones will sing, great are you, Lord. No matter what, we know that all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing, great are you, Lord. Yeah. So we pour out, we pour out. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only. Would you give a shout of praise? Because we know who holds the victory. We know who holds the victory. We give them a shout of praise. Oh, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. You're great and greatly to be praised. Oh, you wear the victor's crown. You wear the victor's crown. Yeah. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We've seen your goodness. We've seen your kindness. Lord, I remember all the days you brought me through. And I remember your goodness. I remember your kindness. And I know that I know that I know you love me. Yes, I know that I know that I know you love me. Oh, it's not complicated. It's not complicated. You came and you gave it all. You gave it all so that I could live. So that I could live with you. Life and life abundantly, and we know that abundant life is life lived in your presence. You came to give us life so that we could live in your presence. We could live in your peace. We could live in your joy. And it's really that simple. It's already done. It's already done. The battle's already won. I don't deserve. I don't deserve. What a gift, what a gift. Oh, I simply receive. Thank you.
words are few. Like a child I reach out just to be with you now. You've held nothing back, Jesus, in steady pursuit. A story composed to bring you back home. Yes, God, yes. You say it's already done. The war for my heart is won. Yes, it is. And it's really that simple. The way that you love me, it's not complicated. I simply receive, yes, I do. It's really that simple. The way that you love me, hallelujah. It's not complicated right here, right now. I simply receive, yes, you held. You held nothing back. In steady pursuit, God, a story composed to bring me back home. Oh, you've brought me home, and you say it's already done. The war for my heart is won. It's really that simple. John tells us that there is no fear in love, because perfect love casts out fear. And I'm sure there are a great many of us in this room that have had that very experience, that when your heart tastes of the love of God, it begins to occupy the space that fear once held. It begins to fill all the room, and there's just no more space for fear to dwell there. Occupies the full space, the love of God. And sometimes the enemy's tactic is to come, and the picture I see is just, he places a ladder in front of us. And he likes to say, climb it. Like, you need to climb this. You need to get to the top to get to the love of God. You need to climb this. And I just want to remind your hearts today that Jesus came down that ladder. He met you. And there's nowhere that you have to climb to achieve, to try, to strive, to get to the love of your Father. It has come to you. It has come to you, and it has come to you right now. And he longs to give you fresh revelation again and again of what it is like and what it means to be loved by Jesus. And it changes everything. Amen. It leaves no room unfilled in your heart. It leaves no space unoccupied in your heart. The love of God wants to fill every space. Because then when it fills, fear has no place to dwell. It's gone. And it's that simple. I don't have to try so hard. I let the love in, and it does the work. I let the love in, and it occupies the space. I let the love in. I let the love of Jesus in, and it fills every hole. It heals every hurt. He wants to heal every hurt. So let the love in. Let his love in. Let it occupy the space. Let it fill your heart today. Let it come. Let it fill every hole. Let it fill. what's already mine. You're already mine. And I don't need to strive for what's already mine. You're already mine. He's already yours today. Sing it out. And I don't need to strive for what's already mine. I simply receive, thank you, Lord. It's really that simple, the way that you love me. It's not complicated. I simply
He loves us. Oh, he loves us. Oh, he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Yes, he loves us. It's really that simple,
yes.
The way that he loves is not complicated. I simply